So I'm driving down to the city to help my friend Luke O'Brien shoot a music video for his new album.
You got a backup cam on that.
Nah, no backup cam.
You did that all just. The
69-point turn.
You're only sticking out like 4 feet or so.
The trick is to not get yourself all the way. Go ahead.
I'm charging him $3.99 because he's a friend and I love him to death. But the whole car ride down, I'm driving there and there's just like 30 million things juggling around in my head, things I need to do. I have shoots coming from all different directions. I have passion projects for myself that I'm trying to work out. I'm trying to take care of my dog. I accidentally let my girlfriend's cat out of the house and I couldn't get it back in the house in time, so I was running late. I was trying to film a YouTube video for you all for this week and something went very wrong while I was trying to film that.
Seems to be a part missing in the package, pretty pivotal part.
I had to completely scrap that idea and I like didn't have time to think of a new video. So yeah, just a general crap storm going around in my head while I'm driving down 76 in a buttload of traffic to film a free music video. Like I'm just thinking to myself, like why am I putting this extra bit of stress on myself? Like how much am I actually benefiting from shooting this free music video right now? I don't even like really want to do music videos for my career. Like you make relatively no money shooting music videos. Like yeah, they're fun, but like I'm trying to focus on my career and make commercials and like maybe narrative stuff, so I need to be focusing there and making money doing those things. So I'm about 5 minutes away from Luke's house where I'm gonna meet him for the shoot, and I get a call from Luke just checking to see what my ETA is, and I told him yeah, I'm about 5 minutes away. We made a couple jokes, he hung up, and instantly in that morning, I was like, damn, like, I love Luke. Like, I'm so happy that we're doing this. Once the shoot got rolling, all the like the little stresses in my mind just kind of flew out the door. Me and Luke were able to catch up, have so much fun running around the city, just creating things together. So I'll play that video that we made later on in this video, but back to the title of this video and why we're here today, I guess. The very best part about being someone who owns a camera is meeting people like Luke. So I met Luke June 10th, 2017.
Are we filming? Are we taking photos?
And the reason I met Luke is that he was performing his first big major music festival of his musician career, and he was playing Firefly in Dover, Delaware, which if you're on the East Coast, you know this is a giant music festival. It's a big deal. And obviously, like, it's a big deal for Luke. He wanted to document the journey along the way, and he needed someone to film that. So somehow I got recommended to Luke, me, just like this new filmmaker, videographer, I guess you would call me at the time. Very little knowledge of what I was doing. Had my little Nikon DSLR.
Yo, yo, check it, got Danny on the camera, man. I got the V750 in the handy cam.
Luke reached out to me and was like, hey, like, wanna come along to Firefly and film like a little like short documentary about my journey? And like, obviously, like that sounds like a ton of fun for someone just starting out. So that's what we did. I met Luke at his house and we spent 3 days at this festival, like barely sleeping, not showering, having the time of our lives together. And driving home together from that trip, we had only spent 3 days together, known each other for 3 days, but I had felt like I had known Luke my entire life. And then from there, we just kept meeting up to make things together. I shot his engagement photos. We shot a music video at his wedding that went like totally viral worldwide.
Since high school, 11th grade when I told you that I liked you. We made good love, had some fights too. Nanny keep asking me when I'm gonna wife you. Ooh, you're too cute, girl. Introduce you to Luke's world.
We've shot weddings together. We've shot music videos together. We both became Lululemon ambassadors together somehow. And just the other day when I went to meet Luke for this shoot, I got to meet him and his wonderful wife's Kathleen's firstborn daughter for the very first time. Her name is Ollie, and she is like probably the cutest baby I've ever seen in my life.
Just woke up from a nap.
Luke like really is one of the kindest and most passionate people I've ever met in my life. He teaches music to underprivileged students. On top of being a father to a newborn, he also fosters a 14-year-old boy. Luke truly is like one of the few true friends I've made in my adult life. And I don't think I would have ever met Luke if I didn't hold a camera in my hands. There's just something about going out and making something with another person. Like you made something together and like you have that thing that you made for the rest of your life. Like it is so incredibly rare for two completely different human beings to link up on the same idea and timing in life and whatever existential topic you want to bring up and come together and make one single thing together. And shooting the other night with Luke was such a good reminder of like how really special it is that like we came together and made something and how lucky I am to be someone who holds a camera. I've met so many unbelievable people, have had so many unbelievable opportunities I never thought I would have had in my life. Because I am a person who holds a camera. Like I've shot videos for Kevin Durant, Odell Beckham Jr. I've been to all across Asia. I've been to Africa. Like all these incredible experiences and people that I've met because I hold a camera. And if you right now are watching me blabbering on right now, like you also are someone who holds a camera. And because you hold a camera, you met me. Pretty awesome. But jokes aside, like the people that you're gonna meet, the places that you're gonna go, the things that you're gonna experience because you're someone that holds a camera, like, let me tell you, like there is like, I don't think there's a better career opportunity for a human being than being you and me. So if you're someone who's like struggling with the idea of like, did I make the right decision buying this camera? Like, let me tell you something. Yes, you made the best decision that you could have ever made. So to everyone I've met along the way and experienced things and created things with because of this camera that I hold, thank you, and you will always have a special place in my heart. In the comments below this video, go make friends. Like everyone in the comments below is here for a reason. Like we're all kind of the same people. Like find someone who lives close to you and connect with those people and maybe they'll become one of your best friends like Luke is for me. And like promise, we're gonna end with the little video that Luke and I made. It's like a sampler video to tease his new album that is coming out August 14th on Spotify. Go check out Luke's channel, go say what's up to him, and yeah, enjoy. And thanks for watching and listening to me. I love you. Bye.
This don't sound right. Yeah, it's just me this time around, y'all. Yeah. I said, welcome to the dope. Here to fill you up with hope. If you listen to my work, know that's always been a trope. Yeah, I keep it all afloat like a feather in the breeze. You know I've been an optimist since 1983. That's just I fell in love with all the colors, all the shades of black and white. I let you in, but just a little, and I left out the rest. Ooh, what'd you expect? You know that I can't let you see me when I'm looking a mess. I was always scared to be a dad. Now I'm here and it's not bad. In fact, it's pretty rad and I'm super stoked.
I thought it would consume all the time I spent on me. But lately I feel blessed and super woke. Pulling on the waves, now I'm shifting. Water all around me and I'm drifting. Life is like the best, did I mention? Everything around me feeling lifted. I just had a baby with my lady, then I went and dropped the album. Counting up my streams while I'm shaking out the talcum. You say you need a thing and you can't do it without one. Think you might have found one, I hope that's working out, bruh. About to be on. You say that one more time and I'm about to be gone. Lukey, when I'm on a track I dookie. Truhee, never had a single thing Gucci. Only got a t-shirt, blue jeans. I just got fans, no groupies. Real peeps who down to earth, who get out of work and come to the show and come out of purse just to watch me do me. I got the whole squad in the Lululemon. I'll be in the studio from noon till 7. My little sis E, my older one Megan. My favorite snack pretzels and my number is 11. Know some big f- We've been exploding for years. Trust me, I've always been here. Yeah, they think I'm trying to reach a milestone, but I'm high on my own. Yeah, we've been exploding for years.
It's a miracle of life. It's an absolute art form. Humans make a human make my whole entire heart warm. The beauty of it all, the rise and the fall, the science and the art, the forest and the mall, the ending and the start, the balance of it all. I was made to spread love, gotta answer my call. So I do, like my ringtone, going off, I'm showing off. Had bad luck, but I'm throwing salt like Lloyd Christmas. Boy, this is so vicious, dedicated and ambitious, yeah. Don't mess with that C base, no beef, I sweepstakes. High heat, that's cremate, no.